Express Tools is a collection of productivity tools which provides additional options and possibilities in BricsCAD. You might already know these tools from AutoCAD. In the older versions of BricsCAD, we have to install Express Tools from the application catalog. But from BricsCAD V23 version onwards, Express Tools is a part of native functionality of BricsCAD. Click on the Express Tools ribbon tab to access these tools, which are categorized in various ribbon panels. Each ribbon panel consists of number of commands and a flyout with additional commands. Let's see some of the commonly used Express Tools. The Arc Text tool creates a text following a selected arc. You can click on this tool. Alternatively, you can also give a command arc text using the keyboard. Click on Arc Text tool. Now you are asked to select an arc or an arc align text. You can input the text at the text box. I'll write arc align text. You can give a suitable height. I'll change the height to 17 units. Give OK. Now the text is written along the arc. Using the same command, you can edit an existing arc align text. Click on arc text and select the text, and you can change the text if required. Now the text is changed. The explode text tool will let you explode a text entity into polylines. Click on explode text and select a text to be exploded and give an enter. Now you can see that the text is converted to 2D polylines. Next, give join command to join all segments to single polylines. Change the view direction using the look from widget to get a top front left view. Let's extrude this text to a certain height. Change the visual style to shaded with edges. Hence, once you explode a text to polylines, it can be edited in a variety of ways, which is not possible on a normal text. Fast select command will let you select entities that touch a specified entity. In this example, suppose if I want to select all the trees which are lying on the boundary of the pathway, all I have to do is just click on fast select and select the pathway, and you can see that all the trees got selected because all the entities in the trees is touching the pathway. These entities will be selected automatically when you give the next editing command. Using the make line type command, we can create a line type based on the selected entities. Let's create few entities. I'll create a line, a text. I want to represent steam lines using this line type. So I'll write the text as steam. Let's create a line type using these entities. Click on make line type. You have to create a line type file. I'll give steam as the line type file name. Click on save. Give steam as the line type name. Give the optional description as steam pipelines. Next, specify the start point and the end point for the line type definition. I'll select the entities using a window. Now you have got a message that steam line type is created and loaded. Click on the home tab and make steam line type as the current line type. Create a polyline using this line type. You can see that it is drawn with that particular line type. Super Offset is an enhanced version of offset command with some additional options. In this drawing, these two wall lines are existing in the walls layer, and there is also a foundation layer. let's execute super offset command. Now you are asked for the offset distance. I'll give 5 as the offset distance. Click on options and you can see 3 options: distance, layer and gap type. The distance is already specified. Click on layer. There are 2 options: source and current. Source keeps the offsetted object in the source layer, whereas the current keeps it in the current layer. The current is chosen, give an enter. Now click on gap type and choose fillet, give an enter, and select the entity to offset and the site to offset. You can see that the offsetted entity is created in the current layer, which is the foundation layer. And when you look at the corners, you can see the formation of fillets because the gap type is chosen as fillet. Similarly, you can also go for chamfer as the gap type. Quick exit command quickly closes all drawings and exits BricsCAD. When you click on this option, the software will ask you whether you want to save the files. Click on yes to save the files and you can exit BricsCAD. This completes the tutorial on Express Tools and application of some of the commands in Express Tools in BricsCAD V23. Thanks for your time.